Hi everybody, welcome back to this tutorial. Now we are going to finish our setup. In the last video we installed PHP Storm and XAMPP, and now we are downloading WordPress, installing it and configuring the database. So for downloading WordPress, simply type wordpress.org/download. Wait until the page loads and then download the WordPress 4.7.5. This can of course be another version when you see this video. Download the actual version and navigate to your downloads file. It's not finished yet, so when it's finished, please extract these files. This needs a little bit. So I can shortly explain you now. You are extracting the WordPress files, which you have to copy to the XAMPP server files. So when you type in your browser, for example, when you type localhost, you want to reach the actual WordPress installation. And this directory where XAMPP reads the files is differing on the operating system. So if you have downloaded in the last video the XAMPP version for Windows, you find your correct directory on your C drive, XAMPP, htdocs, and there you can locate your different WordPress installations if you have more than one. In my case, it's called WP. Remember this, we will need this name afterwards when we are going to import these files in PHP Storm. So let's see if extracting has finished. Yes, you can see the WordPress files here. Take this folder, Control C, and copy it to the XAMPP directory, which is in my case the C drive XAMPP htdocs. If you are using Unix, for example, you can navigate to /var/www, or on Mac I don't really know because I've never used it, and yeah, I don't know it, sorry. So when you copy this file in your correct XAMPP directory, we now have to set up a database. So WordPress needs and requires a database to run correctly. That's why we are going back to our browser. And oh, sorry, one step I've forgotten. First, start your XAMPP server. These both services have to run, Apache and MySQL. And then navigate in your browser to localhost/phpMyAdmin. Enter and wait for the page to load. Here you can see all your databases you have installed on your local system. To add a new database, simply click on Databases, type in the database name. So this would be the demo database, and click on Create. Your database was created. Yeah. So now that we've done this, you have to type localhost/, and then the folder name. So the folder name from the folder you have previously copied the WordPress files. So in my case, this would be WP. In my case, this is already located in this directory. So I have not done this, but you have to copy your WordPress files into this htdocs directory. Then you should see this window when you type localhost/ your folder name. And this is the WordPress installation window. So first, select your correct language. We will choose English for UK. Click on Continue. And WordPress is going to use the correct language files now. So WordPress notifies us we have to know about our database name, database user, password, host, and the table prefix. I'll explain this later. So let's go. Type in your database name. In our case, this was the demo, what was the name? Okay, let's use demo course because I already created this database previously. The username is default root and the password on Windows is default empty. The database host is in our case the local host. If your database server is another server where you install your WordPress, then you would have to type the IP address, for example. And table prefix, this is just the prefix for all the table's names, because you can also install more than one WordPress installations onto one database, and then you have to separate it with this prefix here. WP underscore is the default. So we click submit and can't select database. Oh, sorry. Then I have to see what's the actual database name we've previously created. Demo database. Okay. Let's type the correct database name. Password is empty. Submit. So now WordPress checked all the files and everything seems correct. Now we can run the installation. And the installation is very simple. You only have to set a site title. This is in our course the WP plugin development. Then you have to select a username. In my case, it's simply admin. And the password is hello 1234. So since this installation is on my local computer, it's not really important to have a secure password in this case. On a real world WordPress installation on the real web server, please don't use admin as username and don't use hello 1234 as password, because admin is always the first trial for brute force attacks. Then type your email address, stefan@devcourse.com, and then decide whether to allow search engines to index your site or not. Click on install WordPress and let it go. Just needs a few seconds, I think. Yes, success. Now you can log in with your chosen username and your chosen password. Admin, hello, 1234. Ta-da, here is your finished WordPress installation. So now let's import this into our PHP Storm. When you already have installed your PHP Storm, this window will appear at the very first, and simply click on open, navigate to your XAMPP folder on the C drive, then to htdocs and choose your WordPress directory. In my case, it's WP. Click on OK and let it run. Now it's indexing. Normally there should appear at the right bottom should appear a little alert. There you can enable WordPress support. That means please enable this support, because syntax highlighting is specific for WordPress and it's not specific for PHP itself. So activate this and you will profit, I swear. So, I hope you had a lot of fun and see you in the next videos.